Father in heaven, Father of all creation, Father who owns a cattle on a thousand hills, Father who blesses our land, Father God, we thank you, Master, for the many blessings you've already bestowed upon this land. Father, thank you for America and what America was founded upon, on God, on Christianity, Father God, we thank you. But America has gone astray, Father God. There's so many other things and so many other gods that we've allowed into this place and so many other gods that are being prayed to. But like Minister Dwayne said this morning, there's only one true God. And Father God, we are praying to the one true God. right now, Father God, that you would heal this land. Father God, heal the sicknesses, Father God. All the destruction that's going on, Father God. We have weather-related incidents that's going on in this country, Father God. That many people are suffering right now. Father God, heal this land. Heal this land, Father God. Father God, whoever is in office, whoever wins the election, Father God, we know that you are in control. We have the election to get a president, Father God, but you are God. And before there's none other. You are our leader. And Father God, we call upon your name, Father God, to run this country. Remove anybody else that's not supposed to be there, Father God. Expose them and remove them, Master. And put the men and women of God in the place that they need to be, Father God. Oh, Father God, we're calling on you right now because we know that you're able, Father God. We know that you're able, Lord. And Father God, we call upon you right now that you would heal this land. On Tuesday, Father God, we're praying for peace. And diminished violence, Father God. We know there's going to be some craziness going on around, Father God, but we're praying for peace. The peace of God which passes all understanding, Father God, to just move across this land, Father God, from the seashores all the way through the mountains, Father God, to the prairies, to the ocean, white with snow, Father God. We ask that you would heal this land and give us peace. Let your leaders come up and be leaders, Father God. Let your men and women of God come up and stand up. Let the church stand up and be the church, Father God. We're calling on you right now, Lord. Super Tuesday is still God's Tuesday. So, Father God, we call upon you, Master. We call upon you. And we lean and depend on you. And we have the faith to believe, Father God, that you are Almighty God. And before thee, there's none other. Father God, these are the blessings we ask. In Jesus' name we pray. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Y'all, I was going to preach another message, but God said to preach this message. Amen. The message that I was going to preach is my master satisfied with me? That's the message that's going to come up probably next time, though. Amen. Is my master satisfied with me? And the song says, I am satisfied with Jesus. He's done so much for me. And says, but the question comes to me when I think of Calvary. Come on. Is my master satisfied with me? Church, we should ask that every day. Is my master satisfied with me? It's easy to point fingers at other people and see the wrongs in everybody else. But is my master satisfied with me? Am I doing what thus said the Lord? Am I doing what the Lord told me to do? Is my master satisfied with me? That's going to be the next message, y'all. Amen. Hallelujah. But as I said, we're going to go on. We have so much to pray for right now for this country, y'all. And the title of the sermon is, it's election time, but God is still in control. God is still in control. You know, church, we have an election pretty much every year. But this one, there's going to be some negative ramifications that's going to come out of it. It's okay, because God is still in control. For the past few months, y'all know it, y'all been watching on TV and everywhere, but for the past few months, we've been seeing the commercials, hearing the bickering, the trash slinging between the various candidates. You know, they sound like a bunch of kindergarten children, y'all, fighting over a toy. I want this. Pastor Wesley, he can't do it. Pastor Wesley, he's going to raise the taxes. And Mother Bob, she's going to not protect the borders. Amen. Dr. Jolene, she's going to raise insurance prices. They've been bickering them and on everything, but the same one that's pointing to everybody else, they're not going to do what they're saying. Yeah, I promise I'm going to keep your taxes low. I'm not going to raise your taxes. I promise I'm going to make America great. I'm going to stop right there. Amen. Come on, y'all. Come on. You know, it's just something to see these politicians do these advertisements, these commercials. Don't vote for him. Don't vote for her. Abortion, same-sex marriages, all kind of stuff. The same things that they're talking about and they're talking against, they're the ones that's going to vote for it. They're the one that's going to do things for it. And they're talking against it. It's crazy, y'all. It's crazy to watch our leaders, our politicians, act like children. Act like children. They try to find dirt on the other ones. It's always the Democrats are the bad ones. The Republicans are the bad ones. And they act like they're so squeaky clean. Yeah. Well, there's only one who has done no wrong.
The Lamb.
Come on, somebody say the Lamb. Somebody say Jesus. Y'all both right.
Jesus.
Somebody say God. Y'all right. Amen. It's the Lamb. It's Jesus. It's God. Amen. Only one who has done no wrong. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's already in control of all offices. He's already in control of all things. His name is Jesus, and he's got it all in control. Amen. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
We about to have a good time in the Lord today, y'all. Amen. Amen. You know, but those that are running for office, we need to make sure those that are running for office are standing on Christian values. That they uphold Christian beliefs. They can say what they want to say, but what is their fruit show? What have they been doing? What have they voted on in the past? You can say what you want to say, but what you been doing? Amen. Yeah, that's what we want to know. What's your Christian beliefs are? What are you upholding as far as your Christian values? Amen. God is in control, y'all. And when they finish theirs, they says, this is Cruz, and I've approved this. This is Colin Allred, and I've approved this message. Well, this is Melvin Bouldin. God is in control, and I approve this message. Yeah. Do y'all approve that message? Amen. That God is in control. Yes. This is Melvin Bouldin Jr., and I approve this message. Amen. Amen. God is in control. But you know, y'all, I don't want to bicker on all of them, because they're all not bad. There are some politicians whose hearts are in the right place. I'm going to say that. There are some that have the right motives, but there are many others that don't have the right motives. In the upcoming elections, it doesn't matter who wins, Democrats or Republicans. God is still in control. Our blessings don't come from parties. Our blessings don't come from politicians. Our blessings don't come from governments. It comes from the Lord. Amen. Our blessings come from the Lord. Amen. Somebody say amen. 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 Democrat, Republican, independent, whatever you want to call yourself. Amen. Our blessings come from the Lord.
Amen.
Continue in prayer for this country. Amen. This is a spiritual matter, y'all. We're going to find out a little bit about the spiritual matter that's going on. Another Super Tuesday is up on us, the presidential election. Continue in prayer that God sends us the right man or woman of God, whoever is in office. Now listen to Isaiah, y'all. Listen to Isaiah. This is not the first time that they've had some elections or voting on this or voting on that. It's been happening all along. Amen. But God allows certain people to be in positions and moves them out of position because God is in control.
Amen.
In Isaiah 62:1, it says, because I love Zion, I will not keep still, because my heart yearns for Jerusalem. He's praying for Jerusalem. Are you praying for America? He says, I cannot remain silent. I will not stop praying for her until her righteousness shines like the dawn. We need the righteousness of America to shine. Amen. Amen. America is talking about being great, but are you great in the Lord? Yeah, what are you great in? What great are you talking about? Amen. Make America great again and what? You know, great again from what stuff? What you talking about? You want some other stuff or what? Amen. Amen. Her righteousness shines like the dawn, and her salvation blazes like a burning torch. Isaiah said that he would not remain silent. Are y'all going to remain silent?
Nope.
Are we going to remain silent?
No.
Are we going to stand up and say what thus saith the Lord? In America. In America. America the beautiful. Yeah. America been messing up, y'all. America the beautiful. Amen. Isaiah said he would not remain silent. He would not stop praying for his nation, Jerusalem. We must also pray for the USA. Our nation must call on God. God is waiting on us to pray to him.
Amen.
He's been there waiting all along. Bill talked about that last time. The Holy Spirit is there. You're not even using it. Amen. He's right there waiting on us. Then Isaiah 65:1-2, it says, the Lord says, I was ready to respond, but no one asked for help. God is ready to respond, but nobody ain't asking for help. Amen. Because we got it all in control. We got it. Amen. We can call on American Idol. We call on this. We call on that. We call on professional athletes. No, they don't have an answer for you. Only God can answer. The Lord says, I was ready to respond, but no one asked for help. I was ready to be found. I was ready to be found, but no one was looking for me. Yeah, there's so many that's looking for other things in this country. Nobody's looking for God. Nobody's looking for Jesus. Oh, they'll call on God, but don't bring up Jesus. Yeah, they'll call on God and Jesus, but don't bring up the Holy Spirit. Amen. Yeah, well, what God are you talking about? Our true God, you're going to call on God the Father and God the Son? Somebody help me. And God the Holy Spirit. Yeah, that's the God we call upon. Amen. I don't know what God they talking about, but you got to have God the Father, God the Son, Jesus Christ, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen.
You preaching good.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
The Lord says, I was ready to respond, but no one asked for help. I was ready to be found, but no one was looking for me. I said, here I am, here I am. He said it twice. Here I am, here I am. To a nation that did not call on my name.
Wow.
America, don't be guilty of that.
No.
Help us, Lord.
America, don't be guilty of that. Lamarck, don't be guilty of that.
Come on.
Your house, don't be guilty of that. Your job, don't be guilty of that. You at the job, amen. You should be praying for your job and the people at your job. Yeah, yeah. We there on assignment, y'all. Everywhere you at, you there because you. That's what God wants you to be. But you should be praying for those that are around you right there. Amen? Amen. 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 One nation under God. Let's act like it. Amen.
Yes.
Now, let's talk a little bit about the people that are politicians and those that are candidates for election. Let's talk about that a little bit. We don't put our hope and trust in man.
That's right.
Amen.
In these leaders, we don't put our hope and trust in. We put our trust in the one who is in control. His name is Jesus.
Amen.
All of our blessings come from the Lord, so why not put our trust in the Lord?
Amen.
Amen. The Bible says, church, you about to get blessed. Church, you about to get blessed. Y'all hold on right here. You about to get blessed. All right? Watch Dwayne. Make sure Dwayne don't throw nothing over there. Watch Dr. Joe. Make sure they don't throw nothing. Y'all about to get blessed right here. Amen. Psalm 146, 3 through 6. It says, don't put your confidence in powerful people.
Come on here.
Yes.
There is no help for you there.
None.
When they breathe their last, they return to the earth. And all their plans die with them.
Yeah.
But joyful. Y'all about to get blessed right here. But y'all about to get blessed. But joyful are those who have the God of Israel as their helper.
Yeah.
Whose hope is in the Lord their God. A reminder, y'all. All my help come from?
The Lord.
Let me say it again. A reminder. All my help coming from?
The Lord.
All my help coming from a politician? A president of the United States?
No,
all of my help coming from the Lord. From the Lord who made heaven and earth. He made, Dwayne talked about this one way, y'all, in the sermon. He says he made heaven and earth,
yes,
the sea, and everything in them. Did Trump make everything? But Kamala Harris, did she make all that? Ain't none of them make that. Amen. Only the Lord. Amen. Yeah, he said he made heaven and earth, the sea, and everything in them. He keeps every promise forever. Now they promise stuff.
Oh.
They promise stuff, but can they keep it?
No.
Yeah, can they keep their promise? They make all kind of promises. Do they keep their promises? No, they don't keep their promises. Only the Lord can keep the promise. Amen. When God promises you something, it's going to happen. It's going to happen. Yeah, they don't keep their promises. I got something else to bless you, y'all. I got something. Somebody say amen right quick. Say amen before I even say it. Say amen before I even say it. Hallelujah. This is Psalm 118. Woo! Psalm 118, 8 through 9. Woo! It says, it is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in people. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in princes, than to trust in candidates, than to trust in, oh, it's not in there, I'm just adding this, than to trust in elected officials, than to trust in presidents, than to trust in vice presidents, than to trust in congressmen, than to trust in councilmen. It's better to trust in the Lord than trust in anything else. Anything you can put in the blank, it's better to trust in the Lord in. Amen? Amen. Then I got another one right here. Get ready, y'all. I'm about to throw one. Get your spiritual gloves up. I'm about to throw this one. Get your spiritual gloves up and get ready to catch it. Jeremiah 17, 5 through 8. This is about to bless you. Jeremiah 17, 5 through 8. This is what the Lord says.
Ooh.
Cursed are those who put their trust in mere humans.
Yeah.
Did y'all hear that?
Yeah.
Cursed are those who put their trust in any presidential election. Or any congressman, anybody else. Cursed are those putting their trust in anybody else. Amen. Put their trust in mere humans who rely on human strength, which is nothing. Human strength is nothing compared to God's strength.
Amen.
Who rely on human strength and turn their hearts away from the Lord. But turn their hearts away from the Lord. They are like stunted shrubs in the desert. Oh, we're about to go somewhere right here. With no hope for the future. They will live in the barren wilderness. In an uninhabited salty land, but blessed are those who trust in the Lord and have made the Lord their hope and covenant. They, us, y'all, they are like trees planted along the riverbank with roots that reach deep into the water. Such trees are not bothered by the heat, are worried by long months of drought. Their leaves stay green, and they never stop producing fruit.
Thank you, Lord God.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say amen again.
Amen.
Now, we about to break this down, y'all. You know we're going to break it down now. You know we got to break this down. Amen. Y'all get ready.
We ready.
It says that such trees are not bothered.
Uh-oh.
Such trees are not bothered by the heat. Such trees are not bothered by the stock market crashes. Such trees are not bothered by interest rates. Such trees are not bothered by skyrocketing insurance bills. Such trees are not worried about those who are in office. Such trees don't worry about what's happening on the job. Such trees don't worry about any of that. Such trees are not worried about long months of drought, layoffs, medical costs, insurance rates increasing. Such trees' leaves stay green, and they never stop producing fruit. Such trees have deep roots. We about to go right there. Such trees got deep roots. Ha! When the storms of life blow in your life, such trees have deep roots. When the doctor gives you a bad report, such trees have deep roots. When trees have deep roots, when somebody's always trying to frustrate you, or backstab you, put you down, such trees have deep roots. Rooted and grounded in who? Rooted and grounded in who? In Jesus. Rooted and grounded in Jesus, no matter what comes our way. No matter how the winds and the waves come up, we are rooted and grounded in the Lord. That means we stand on firm ground. We shall not be moved. Like a tree planted by the river, I shall not be moved. No matter what goes on in the society, we shall not be moved. Because we are rooted and grounded in Jesus.
Amen.
I told y'all about to be blessed. Amen. Told you about to be blessed. I'm just not getting to the opening scripture. I won't be long. I won't be long. 1 Chronicles chapter 29, 10 through 11 is what we have. But we got to go 10 through 14.
Okay.
10 through 14. What if we had a leader like David in this country? What if we had a leader like David, like King David who prayed for his nation? 1 Chronicles 29, 10 through 14. It says, then David praised the Lord in the presence of the whole assembly. Yeah. Then the president of the United States of America praised the Lord in the presence of the whole country. Mm-hmm. Wouldn't that be nice? Yeah. Wouldn't that be nice to see something like that?
Yeah.
David says, oh Lord, the God of our ancestor Israel, may you be praised forever and ever. Yeah. Yours, oh Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the victory and the majesty. Everything in the heavens and all on earth is yours, O Lord. This is your kingdom. This land is your land. This land is my land from California. No, it ain't your land. It ain't my land. It's God's land. Amen. They need to revamp that song. Amen. Revamp it. It's God's. Hallelujah. Amen. Verse 12, it says, wealth and honor come from you alone. I'll say that again. Wealth and honor come from you alone. We try to get it everywhere else and try to find it everywhere else, but it comes from God alone.
Yes.
Wealth and honor comes from you alone. For you rule over everything.
Everything.
You rule over everything. Power and might are in your hand. This is Dwayne, right hand. Amen. Power and might are in your hand. And at your discretion, people are made great and given strength. At whose discretion? At God's discretion are people made great. Amen. Some people think that they're great on their own. Some of our politicians or some of our electors are thinking that they're great on their own. It comes from God. And it can be taken away by God.
Amen. Oh, yeah.
Nebuchadnezzar. I need to talk about Nebuchadnezzar a little bit. Who thought he was all that? Yeah. Nebuchadnezzar, can he take it away from you? Yeah, he took it from me. For 7 years, I was crawling around. Thank you. Thank you, Nebuchadnezzar. Thank you. Amen. Amen. So it can be taken away, just like it was given. And it says, at your discretion are people made great and given strength. Oh, our God, we thank you and praise your glorious name. This King David. This is the leader of a country. That's just praying like this is. This is the leader of a country. It says, but who am I?
Who am I?
And who are my people that we could give anything to you? Because he owns everything.
Come on.
But we can give a sacrifice of praise.
You better.
We can give him a praise of him and worship him.
We better.
Amen. We can give him prayers. We can give him us. We can give him the best of us.
Come
amen.
On
That's
now.
What we can give. Amen.
Yeah.
What can we give? What shall I render unto God for all he's done? All I can render is my body and my soul.
Come on. Yeah.
I can give me. Give him me. Give him you. Amen.
Yeah.
Give it all to him. Amen. Amen. It says, but who am I? And who are my people that we can give anything to you? Everything we have comes from you. And we give you only what you gave us. How you going to give God something that he don't have already?
Oh, God.
Yeah,
come on,
how you going to give God something he already have? But you got, he gave it to you. Amen. How we going to give him anything? Amen. Amen. But we can give him our body and our soul. We can give him all of us. Amen. Amen. What shall I render unto God? Amen. Hallelujah. Let church say amen.
Amen.
Oh, if we had a leader like that who really knows who is in control.
That's right.
If we had a leader that knew who really was in control. Instead, we have many false leaders like those mentioned in the book of Micah. I'm going to go to the book of Micah, y'all. I'm not going to be long. I know we got a communion. This is the book of Micah. This is not the first time that we see leaders build themselves up with untruths to get a leadership position. Many of them just want a leadership position. That's all they want. They want some power. They want what they think is power. In the book of Micah, kind of like Jonah, Mr. Dwayne, Micah is another prophet sent by God to warn the people of Judah and Israel of punishment for their sins. In chapter 2, it talks about evil, greedy people who use, steal from, and get over on others. Does that sound like America a little bit? Okay. All right. Chapter 2, verse 1 through 2. It says, what sorrow awaits you who lie awake at night, thinking up evil plans.
Uh-oh.
You rise at dawn and hurry to carry them out, simply because you have the power to do so.
Woo!
When you want a piece of land, you take it.
Yep.
Fraud, violence, cheating, stealing. That's what they do. Church, there are greedy leaders out there, and it seems like they've been getting away with things. They've been getting away with things that are wrong for so long. Oh, but look at chapter 2, verse 3. But the Lord says, I will reward your evil with evil. You will no longer walk around proudly, for it will be a terrible time.
Mm.
Yeah, those that are doing wrong and getting over in our country, yeah, that time is coming. We serve a God of suddenly. Amen. That was another book that I was going to bring up. A God of suddenly, who lets them do things for so long, and then suddenly God steps in and takes them out of them. Amen. Verse 2, chapter 2, verse 4. It says, in that day your enemies will make fun of you. There is greed and corruption on every level, even in our government. Chapter 3, verse 9 through 11. I told you I'm going through Micah real quick. Chapter 3, verse 9 through 11. It talks about the corrupt leaders in Israel. Chapter 3 and 11. You rulers make decisions based on bribes. Do y'all know there are a lot of people that's in position, places that are lobbyists? You know what lobbyists are? Lobbyists are those that are running for a position, and they are being backed by somebody else that they can do for them.
Right.
In other words, a businessman wants this here politician in, and they'll do it, raise all kind of money, bring them in there, but they want them in there so they can benefit.
That's it.
Amen. That's called lobbyists. That's called lobbyists. Amen. It says, now, and as I said, the legal term used in America, the legal term, because it's crooked. It's not right. It's crazy. It says, now the legal term used in America today is lobbyists, which are people who support politicians for their own business or cause. Although all are not corrupt, there are a great amount of them who are.
That's right.
That's true.
Chapter 3, verse 1. It says, you are the leaders of Israel. You are supposed to know right from wrong. God is something else, boy. He said, you are the leaders of Israel. You're supposed to know right from wrong. You're supposed to know better. You're supposed to know right from wrong. But you are the very ones who hate good and love evil. Yeah, the big butt. That was the big butt. Amen. Amen. To continue, verse chapter 3 and 11. It says, priests, let me throw in pastors and preachers in there too. Priests teach God's law only for a price. You prophets won't prophesy unless you are paid. This is from the book of Micah. Back then, y'all, it's the same thing happening right now. It says, God's law only for a price. You prophets won't prophesy unless you are paid. Today, many popular prophets and preachers won't show up unless there's a certain amount of money involved. Profit for profit.
Mm.
Yeah, it's a lot that happened back then, but it's a whole lot happening right now. Chapter 4, verse 11. I'm almost done. Yet all of you claim to depend on the Lord. Now they say they claim to be on the Lord. They believe in Jesus. They believe in God. They say it with their mouth, but their heart is far from. Okay. Amen. Yet all of you claim to depend on the Lord. Oh, but there's good news for God's people. Chapter 2, 12 through 13. Mother Bob loves to talk about the remnant. There's always a remnant, Mother Bob. Here's a remnant right here. Chapter 2, it says, there's a remnant who will be blessed. Restoration for God's people. And that's chapter 2, verses 12 through 13. And then we're going to find out, as we find that, when we go through the book of Micah, we're going to end right here. It says, yeah, now here comes Jesus, y'all. Jesus is going to always show up, y'all. He's going to always show up. Here comes Jesus. It says, he was already there. Well, oh, yeah. Amen. Y'all about to make me go Baptist. Oh, Lord. Come on, y'all. Don't make me go Baptist up in here. Amen. Amen. 2 and 3. It says 2 and 13. Your leader will break out and lead you out of exile. Your king, I'm talking about Jesus. Your king will lead you. The Lord himself. Ooh. Oh, man. All right.
All right.
Lord, I'm about to, I almost went somewhere, y'all. The Lord himself will guide you. The Lord himself will guide you.
Thank you,
the Lord himself will guide you. Christians, today, the Lord himself will guide you.
Yeah.
When you go to the poll to vote, if you haven't already, pray to the Lord and he will
guide
you.
Yeah.
He will guide you. Trust in the Lord. Pray to him before you make your selection or whatever you're doing. Let God lead you. He will guide you. He will drive guide you. And y'all, you know, the church, y'all, the rapture, so much is going on right now. The rapture is so soon.
Yes.
It is so soon. Sooner than many think.
Amen.
In the book of Daniel, and I'm going to finish here. I told y'all it wasn't going to take long, y'all. I got to go this. One more game. Amen. The book of Daniel, chapters 9 through 12. We see this heavenly battle going on in Daniel's chapter 9 and 10.
Come on.
I told y'all this is a spiritual thing.
Come on.
This is a spiritual thing that's going on in this country. And it always has been.
Always.
It's always been a spiritual thing. Daniel chapter 9 and 10. In Daniel 9, 20 through 23, Daniel was praying about a vision he had, and the angel, some say it was Gabriel, an angel showed up and explained the vision. In chapter 10, Daniel was fasting and praying for 21 days, but it took 21 days to get the answer from God.
All right.
Because a powerful evil spirit was blocking the angel.
Come on, tell it.
The angel had to call on one of the archangels, Michael. Now, when Michael showed up, things about to happen.
Man,
you know, when Michael showed up, it's about to go down.
Yeah,
he don't want to mess with Michael too much, y'all. Cause, Michael is called the warring angel. He get the beat down quick. Amen. All right, here we go. The angel had to call on one of the archangels, Michael, to help. See, y'all, there is a spiritual, real spiritual fight going on around us. In Daniel chapter 11, the angel begins to explain the dream that Daniel had. God's people cannot be fooled by those who use flattery to fool others.
Amen.
Because there's something else happening in the spiritual realm.
Yes.
We, as God's people, have spiritual discernment.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
We hear what they're saying.
Yes.
We should.
We are not just listening. We hear what they're saying.
Come on.
In the spirit realm, we've got to pray.
That's
when they get up and debate and get up and talk, in the spirit realm, we've got to pray for it. And we've got to do our research on it too. Do a back check. See what all they're talking about is true. See what they've done in the past. See what they're saying is just flattery of the tongue.
That's what we should do.
It says Daniel chapter 11, 29 to 32. It shows in Daniel chapter 11, 29 to 32, it shows a charismatic king who rose to power and was changing God's law. A charismatic king who rose to power and was changing God's laws. A charismatic king who rose and started changing God's laws. We've been there, y'all. We've already had some laws that have been changed. But believe me, there are going to be a lot more that they're going to try to change. God's laws. That's a bad place for them to be.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
Verse 11, chapter 11, verse 32. It says that this person, he will flatter and win over those. He's going to talk real good, or she is going to talk real good, and they'll win over people. But the people who know their God will be strong and resist him. I said those people who know their God will be strong and resist him. Do you know God? If we know the Lord, we're going to be strong and resist whatever they're saying. If they say anything that's contrary to God's word, we resist it.
Amen.
We do not stand for it. We resist it.
Amen.
But the people of God will be strong and resist him. Many leaders are rising to power and are changing laws and perverting America. But we must not be fooled by the flattery of the tongue. There are people around us who try to fool, use, or get over on us. But we belong to God. And we know what they're doing. We can see what they're doing with the spiritual heart. We can see what's happening, what they're saying. You know, as I said, y'all, election time is coming up. We really need to pray for spiritual wisdom and discernment. Even with wisdom, we still may suffer some. Y'all, there's going to be some suffering. God, he never said that we weren't going to have any suffering. We're going to have some suffering, but he'll be with us in it. Amen. Yeah, that's good news. When you go through something, he'll be with you. Yeah, that's good news. Ask Jonah. Jonah wasn't by himself, y'all. Jonah went through some stuff, but God was with him. Yeah, he was in the belly of a whale, fish, crocodile, alligator, whatever it was. He was in the belly, but he was with them. He could have been with a shark. He could have been with Jaws. Jaws couldn't bite him. You know, amen, because God is with him, amen. Don't. You just hear the music. Ain't nothing happening to Daniel on the inside. Jonah's on the inside. Ain't nothing happening to him. Amen. But it says here, Daniel chapter 11, 35. Some of the wise will fall victim to persecution, but in this they will be refined, cleansed, and made pure. Sometimes we go through some things to be refined, cleansed, and made pure. Some sufferings that we go through is to have us to be refined, cleansed, and made pure. Daniel chapter 12 and 10. Now, this I'm going to end right here because this is the end. Amen. I'm going to talk about the end right here a little bit. Amen. Daniel chapter 12 and 10 is referring to the end times. But it says that many will be purified, cleansed, and refined by these trials. But the wicked will continue their wickedness. This is called the tribulation, y'all. It's going to happen. The wicked will continue their wickedness, and none of them will understand. They don't even know what they're doing. The wicked don't even know what they're doing half the time. Sometimes they think they're doing stuff for the Lord, and they're doing something wicked. They don't even realize they're doing it. It says, but only those who are wise will know what it means. What did I say, y'all? Only those that who are wise will know what it means. The things that's going on around us, only those who are wise will know what it means. All the struggles and things that we may be going through around us, only those who are wise, amen, and know what it means. Only God's people are wise enough to know what's going on. Only God's people know this is the end times. Only God's people know the tribulation is coming up, but only God's people know that the rapture will happen first. Only God's people know that we won't go through a tribulation. We go through suffering and persecution right now. Things that are happening bad right now. But only God's people know that we will be raptured out of here before the tribulation happens. Isn't that good news? Let the church say amen. Amen. And y'all, it's election time, but God is in control. It's election time, but God is in control. Somebody stand up on your feet and say hallelujah. Say hallelujah. It's election time, but God is in control. God is in control. My name is Melvin Bouldin. And I endorse this message. Amen. Let's church say amen. Let's church say amen. Amen. The doors of the church are open.
Amen.
The doors of the church are open. Oh, hallelujah.
Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Yes, Lord. Thank you. The doors of the church are now open to W1. Who would like to give your life to Christ? Accept Jesus Christ. Confess it with your mouth and believe in your heart. And mighty. Oh, the King. Was mighty in battle. Never lost one. Never lost a battle. Never lost a game. Of glory. He shall come in. We extend this welcome. We extend this invitation. One thing before we have our benediction, y'all. So Pastor Pope, I don't know if y'all heard about it, but he's going to be an apostleship service next week. He's going to be named as an apostle. It's supposed to be next week. Not sure if it's going to be at 3 o'clock or what time it's going to be, and I'll let you all know when I find out. But I'm just so happy for Pastor Pope. Amen. 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 Status of apostle, that's awesome, y'all. That's awesome. Awesome. It couldn't happen to a more humble person. Person that's been in the Word for such a long time. It's just just really wonderful. It's just really awesome. Amen. Amen. Well, y'all, if there'll be anything else?
Pastor, I
want to
let y'all know next week I'm going to have my own surgery on the 7th. And I want to thank God for blessing me because like, I've been through it and everybody been through it. I went out to the hospital. Mm-hmm. They told me about bones. And I did ask God about it. And I asked him, I'm like, what man look at so? And he told me like, you never fail, man. I'm with you.
All right. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And I went up there, they treated me and my doctor told me about I need to take a lot of medicine. I thought real hard about it, and I asked God for it. He said, hey, I'm your mess.
Come on, man.
You say, you get what you say?
That's right.
Because I thought little myself, my cousin was crying. And I asked him, why you crying? He said, I don't want to lose you. And it just made me broke down when she said it.
Yeah.
And just, I want y'all to know because I know I did a lot of things, but God always here. And he hear a lot of things.
Amen. Amen. It's all right, Kenny. Amen, y'all. The doors of church is now open. He just preached another message. Amen. That was another message, Kenny. That was awesome. That's awesome. And we got to continue to lift Kenny up in prayer, y'all.
Yeah.
God continues, and as soon as we find out something about it, then we'll let you all know what's going on with the surgery. And also with Marie, Sister Marie, also with her surgery that's supposed to be this week as well. Mm-hmm. Amen. All right. Anybody else? Anything else? All right. We're going to have our benediction if you can stand.
I want to lift up my niece. She fighting now. She got cancer in her womb.
Okay.
Right now, she's taking radiation and chemo.
Amen. What's her name?
Oh, I don't see what her name is.
That's right. God knows her name.
No, not Jessica. Jeannie's granddaughter.
All right. God knows her name. God knows her name. Amen. He knows all about it. He knows her name. Amen. And y'all, once again, pray for this country. Tuesday, just pray for this country. Pray for peace in this country. Amen. Amen. Let's go.
Digna.
Digna? Digna. Okay, Digna. All right. Let's go to God and pray, y'all.
Thank you, Lord.
Father in heaven, we just want to thank you, Father God, for everything that's happened on today, Father God, from the awesome Sunday school lessons, yes, to the scripture reading, to the awesome altar prayer, Father God, to the praise and worship singing, Father God. Thank you for the preached word of God, Father. We just thank you for all that's happening for our communion also, Father God. Thank you for all of the body of believers that are here, Father God. We thank you, Father God. Continue to bless us and use us in a mighty way. Lead God and direct us in the way that you would have us to go, Father God. Father, we thank you for the many blessings you've already bestowed upon whosoever will, Father God. We just ask you continue to watch over, protect us, Father. Those that are here also, and there's some that are traveling on the road right now. We do pray for traveling grace for them as well. Father, for those that are about to go through surgery, Father God, we're praying for Digna. Father God, we're praying for Kenny. We're praying for Sister Marie, Father God. We pray that you continue to heal their bodies, Father God, as they get ready to go through the surgery, Father God. That you would guide those that are involved, the surgeons, Father, doctors, that they make the right decisions, Father God, that everything goes well. And then that they have a praise report when they come back, Father God. Master, we just want to thank you for all that's happened on today, Father God. And we just give you glory, honor, and praise, Father God. With this election time coming up, Master, we know that you are in control, Father God. You are still in control, Father God. And we just thank you, Master. And we trust in you, God. We don't trust in man. We trust in you, Father God. And we just want to say thank you, Father God. Thank you for what you're about to do, Master. We thank you, Father God. We give you glory, honor, and praise. Now may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide with us now, henceforth, and forevermore. Let the church say amen. 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 You are dismissed. Hallelujah.